Welcome to episode 56 of Optional U. I'm your host, Amanda Jacobsen.
And I'm Matthew Byrd. We're here at the Liberty Mountain Snowflex Center, the only year-round ski slope in the U.S.
Snowflex has ski hills for every type of skier, from novice to expert.
Let's check out this week's segments as we explore this awesome facility.
This week, Big Backyard takes us downtown to a nationally known charity.
Jasmine shows us how we can get involved and help out those in need.
Show, we usually like to show you what you can do around Lynchburg for entertainment. This week, we'd like to show you what you can do to serve the community who lives in your big backyard.
The Salvation Army began in 1852. Its goal has always been to reach and serve the poor and the hungry. For hundreds of years, volunteers have been able to turn this goal into a reality.
I'm a big advocate for being part of the community and getting involved. And I think helping these people and knowing that we take so much for granted. And so coming out here has really, really shown me that there are those that are less fortunate that we can help out. And it's really eye-opening here. One time there was one guy in here who was singing his Valentine's Day, and he was singing songs, I guess, and he was an older guy, so he was singing from songs when he was a kid, I guess. And everybody that was working back here was just like clapping, like cheering along. Like, it was just really sweet. And he was one of the guys that, one of the residents that lives here.
The Lynchburg Salvation Army is no different. They use volunteers to give meals to our local community every single day. If you'd like to help, the Center for Hope in downtown Lynchburg is in need for volunteers to help serve breakfast. This is your chance to get out of the Liberty bubble and to make a positive impact on the community around us.
If you'd like to volunteer for the Lynchburg Salvation Army, visit their website or give them a call. I'm Jasmine Martin for Optional U.
Even though Liberty University is one of the largest schools in the U.S., the student-to-teacher ratio is only 25-1.
And there's a big emphasis on getting to know the students, just like in our next segment, Student Spotlight.
Hi, I'm Camille Chucks of Student Spotlight. Michael Hiskey, a junior here at Liberty, was 18 years old when he found his first organization. Stay tuned to hear more information about this organization and his testimony.
Hi, I'm Michael Hiskey. I'm a junior here at Liberty University. I study graphic design. I just got married a month ago. In high school, I switched a lot between different schools. My sophomore year, I switched to a local private school where I met my now wife, and I went there until my senior year. Private school and public school are very different. I would say private school, it was definitely an encouragement for me, having professors and more friends that really cared. During my senior year of high school, my best friend committed suicide. This kind of sent me into a tailspin, because he was one of my friends that I went to and would talk about things, and we both felt like we weren't being listened to, and sometimes felt like we weren't understood by society. His name was Joe Flora. He was the Joe that created everybody's Joe somebody. I always knew I wanted to help people, and that it was important to be heard and listened to. I always felt like I should wait till I was more established and older and either had the finances or was a grown-up that I should start an organization then. But when my friend Joe committed suicide, it really was almost like a Jonah moment for me, and just God saying, you need to be doing this now, people who need help now. Not later, not when it's convenient for you. If you'd like to check it out, it's everybodysjoesomebody.com.
Michael, How would you say you manage your academics, marriage, and your ministry?
Coffee.
If you can give anyone advice for someone who would want to start an organization, what advice would you give them?
I would say just to start talking to their friends, start talking to people just to get the word out there and see what other people have to say about it, and try to just start it. That's the best thing. I started Everybody's Joe Somebody. The first year was purely on my dime, and I just went out there and knew I needed to do it, and just started getting my word out there, funding concerts or however I could do possibly.
Well, for Student Spotlight, I'm Camille Checks.
One of the greatest aspects about the degree programs here at Liberty is that projects are completed with real-world experience in mind.
This week, Artistic Liberty focuses on Design Wars, a competition held within the Department of Studio and Digital Arts.
Hey guys, welcome to Artistic Liberty. The Department of Studio and Digital Arts may be tucked back here in a corner of DeMoss that the average student doesn't visit that often, but this is one of the fastest growing majors on campus and big things are happening here. Right now, the department is holding a competition called Design Wars. Let's go find out more about it.
The idea was developed within the context that we need to give students real world experience.
It's open to current Liberty graphic design majors and minors. The competition is made up of three battles. The first battle, which was branding, has already taken place and points have been awarded to students who submitted their work. Battle 2 will be packaging, and Battle 3 will be a poster and campaign series.
I decided to do Design Wars because I thought it would be a great way to see how my work compared with those of my peers here at Liberty, and just how my work is in general. I've gotten teachers' comments on assigned projects, but actually doing something completely on my own with my own rules and regulations, I thought it'd be neat to see what judges and different students thought of my work and how it ranked with other people here at Liberty. And it was fun.
A real world environment where they're competing against one another, but in a sense that replicates what's done in the industry when you have to compete against other companies, agencies, for the work that a client might have.
The winner of Design Wars will be determined based on a point system that carries through all three parts of the competition. Points are awarded based on ranking of each student's work, which is decided by a different judge in each stage of the contest. Design Wars is sponsored by Liberty's branch of AIGA, which is the Professional Association for Design. Keep up with the rankings in each battle and find out who wins it all. Visit AIGA at Liberty on Facebook. For Optional U, I'm Rachel McCormick.
We hope you've enjoyed the first half of Optional U. Stay tuned because we got some more segments coming up next.
If you have ideas for any future segments, make sure to check out our Facebook page or tweet us at Optional U.
Hello and welcome to Optional U. I'm Deli.
And I'm Lenore. In today's episode, we'll check in with Big Backyard, Sports, Student Spotlight,
The Big Man, and then finally close it up with your Champion Connection. It's all coming to you
right now.
That was actually the Big Man on the phone.
Hey! I'm Sarah Wells for Optional U.
Well, obviously our tagline is for students, by students, and about students. And it really is. That just gives students like myself the ability to learn, just kind of thrown out there with guidelines, and you just kind of go for it, which is so awesome.
I've either edited my work, shot my work, or I've showcased, you know, hosting on TV in the greater Lynchburg area.
You know, it's just good to keep people involved with Liberty University and what goes on around campus, and from a student's perspective.
And Optional U gives, you know, students here, especially freshmen, and I know even as a senior, the ability to realize what's going on around them, that there's more to Liberty than just, you know, this their little bubble of their dorm or their little bubble of their circle of friends or their classes, but there's a lot of things that Liberty and Lynchburg has to offer them.
Having to come up with ideas every other week and then making them actually happen has created us to be really prompt and professional.
The students really have something to put out and show for what work they've done.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to another edition of the Champion Connection. I'm Jessica Young.
And I'm Mike Johansson.
First up on the Champion Connection, have you ever wanted to become a lifeguard? Well, Liberty University is partnering with the American Red Cross to offer students the opportunity to become certified lifeguards. Classes will be held in Green Hall and the LaHaye Student Union Swimming Pool on Liberty's campus. Upon passing the course, each person will be certified in CPR, AED, and first aid. This certification will last for 2 years. There will be 3 classes offered this spring with the following dates: February 21st, March 20th, and April 10th. In the past, these classes have been fairly small, but this semester they are filling up fast. The course is being offered to Liberty students, staff, and military personnel at a discounted rate of $250. If you would like more information or to register, visit www.safetyclass.org.
You know, Jessica, that sounds like a really great deal, especially for the price.
Yeah, I was a lifeguard for years, and those skills really come in handy.
All right, well, this next segment has nothing to do with cars or robots. Here's Sharina reporting on the iTransform event.
Hey, I'm Sharina Harvey for Optional News Champion Connection. I'm here tonight at the iTransform event. Let's go check it out.
The iTransform event was a great experience that was produced by Student Care. The event started with a walkthrough. The walkthrough consisted of 4 different stations. The first part of the iTransform walkthrough allowed everyone to take a powerful word from the wall that described their relationship with God. They then were able to take a picture with the word. The picture was then transferred to the big screen in the room next door. The next walkthrough station gave everyone the opportunity to watch a life-changing video. The third station consisted of a survey. The survey was able to explain how each individual really spends their time and how much time is really devoted to God, depending on their answers. To finish the walkthrough, another powerful video was shown. Everyone then made their way over to the next room, where the Dean of Students, Pastor Keith Anderson, shared his strong testimony and his transformed experience.
And I need you to come into my life in such a way that I'll know you're talking to me and that I can trust you.
After the event, I had the opportunity to see what some of the students thought.
I took away that as believers, we have a duty to draw closer to the Lord, and through that, our neighbors and fellow believers, it helps us to basically transforming what we do. I basically said, I transform.
After the event, students, visitors, and faculty left feeling inspired, transformed, and ready to encourage others.
For Optional News, Jubilee Connection, I'm Sharon.
Known as the Jubilee Family Development Center, has recently been featured on the Oprah Winfrey Network. OWN recognized Executive Director Sterling Wilder on their 92nd Everyday Hero segment. The Jubilee Center opened in downtown Lynchburg in 1999 after awareness was raised about the amount of low-income residents near Florida Avenue. The center offers after-school help for elementary through high school students until 6 p.m. Wilder has been honored for his good deeds. In 2000, Wilder received the Use Your Life Award on The Oprah Winfrey Show. Wilder will be featured on the Everyday Hero segment now through March 21st at Wednesdays at 8 and 11 p.m.
Hey guys, love music, love movies? How about a combination of the both? I'm here at the Sindor Performance Hall down at Lynchburg College for the Wind Symphony's Night at the Movies. Let's go check it out.
Lynchburg College hosted a Night at the Movies, where bands from both Liberty University and Lynchburg College collaborated to perform selections from various movie scores. The movies highlighted were The Soloist, Ratatouille, Hook, The Terminal, Star Wars, The Sound of Music, and many more. Clips or trailers from the movies were shown before the ensembles performed them. I got a chance to talk to Eden Jones, a violinist for the Liberty University Symphony Orchestra.
How did you like the collaboration with you and Lynchburg College? How did that work out?
It was really neat. It was a great experience to play with them and, you know, meet some of the other musicians. And yeah, I think it worked out really smoothly, and hopefully we'll get to do it again sometime.
How many hours of practice did you put into this?
We've had the music for probably about 4 weeks now, so I'd say roughly 3 hours a week.
Well, thank you so much for talking with me, Eden. Reporting for the Champion Connection, this is Hannah Elliott.
Well, thanks, Hannah, and that wraps up another edition of the Champion Connection.
Make sure to pick up your free copy of the Liberty Champion or check them out online at libertychampion.com.
We'll see you all next week, everyone.
So, Amanda, how's that bullying by spring coming along?
Well, I guess we'll see what happens, but let's hope I get luckier than Anessa in Student Obsessions.
Yo, Austin, what's up, man?
Oh, what's up, Ty? Doing all right?
Guess what?
What?
Someone just got engaged in the Vine Center.
Are you kidding me? In the Vine Center?
Yeah.
Dude, man, I met this guy the other day. He was single. Hit this girl up on Facebook. Typical. They start dating, like, right away. Now he's thinking about marrying her.
I know, right? Check out these two.
What's up?
Like, she's probably expecting a ring by spring.
Poor guy.
Yo, babe, I just love hanging out with you.
Can you say that to my eyes?
Why, you don't trust me?
Oh, I trust you.
It's crazy, though. Can't wait to see what the future holds for us, yeah?
It's almost like we're married.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, the grass was like,
sucked.
I felt
so. What's up?
Just here a minute ago.
Okay. Well, you guys are his best friend, right?
Yeah, why?
Just asking. He didn't happen to mention about a ring, did he?
I mean, I know he just ordered a class ring.
Oh, yeah?
But other than that, I don't think so. Like, that's about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right?
Okay, right. So what I was saying is that this boy better marry me, because this will be my fifth boyfriend this semester, and I am going to be angry, flabbergasted. I don't know what I'm going to do with myself if he doesn't marry me. So, oh, hold on. He's coming right now. I'll call you right back.
Oh, hey.
Hey. Hey, babe, look.
Hi.
I'm meaning to tell you something.
Okay.
You know what? I'm gonna have to hold that. I'll talk to you soon. Look, I promise. I'll make it up. I got it.
Yo!
I think something is wrong with my girlfriend. She's talking about me getting married?
I knew something was wrong with that chick.
Dude, yeah, you gotta drop that, man.
Yo, look, I'm just trying to focus in school, but every time I talk about stuff, she talks about relationships, getting married. You know what? Look, I gotta go, man. I gotta meet up with her.
Alright, man. Well, tell her we said hey.
Hey, look, I'm so sorry. My bad.
So what'd you need to tell me?
So, do you prefer a clean shaven or a goatee?
When you come from a country where the average temperature is around 80 degrees, it's probably hard to figure out why people would jump into an icy lake in the middle of winter. Here's Tachi finding out why in America 101.
Well, the water is freezing and I'm here at the Polar Plunge for another adventure of America 101. Today, I am not really sure what's going to happen. I heard that some people are going to get in this freezing lake. And it's all about raising funds. My idea about fundraising is not really getting into this freezing weather, water. It's awful out here, but we're gonna go out and talk to some people and find out why they're here. So let's go. It's freezing out here, and I am not really sure what this whole polar plunge is. What is plunging, first of all?
Okay, well, first of all, you have to raise $50, and all the proceeds go to Special Olympics. So even though it's absolutely freezing, it'll be really fun jumping with everyone, knowing it's for a really good cause.
Okay, but so why doing this? Why not just, like, baking cookies and trying to sell for race funds?
Well, this is our fifth year doing this, but this is the biggest year we've ever had with it. So I think the reason we do the Polar Plunge, it's kind of a Special Olympics tradition across the country, and it really gets the name out there more and showing that we're willing to take risks to really help people.
And, like, I don't know if this is a dumb question, how long people stay in the water? Do they just, like, go in and jump out?
This is my first plunge, but my plan is to go in, like, show my support, and run out to some heaters and some blankets.
And an event like this,
it takes a lot of courage to jump in the freezing cold water. I mean, it's cold. Yeah. I felt it earlier. So, you know, and it's just a way for us to show our own courage and represent ourselves and show, you know, put ourselves out there to do this for them. They every day they you know, are out there being examples of courageous people. Our athletes are mainly people with intellectual disabilities, and they go out in the workforce and they work full-time jobs. They, you know, they go out and they shop themselves. They do everything we do. They just do it differently. So this is one way for us to fundraise in an awesome way, in a very unique way, and be courageous ourselves and jump in freezing cold water to benefit them.
It seems like they're getting ready to do this crazy plunging thing. I thought some people would give up on it and see it's getting quiet. I think people are getting scared, but they're gonna go for it. They raised $22,000. This is incredible. I think there are more than 150 people here to jump in this freezing water, and they're ready. One, two, three, and... Here we have two girls that just plunged. Your name is?
Annadelle.
Kelsey.
All right, why did you guys decide to plunge?
To say that we could do it. We didn't think we could.
It was just like off a whim thing. We saw it and we were like, let's do it.
So, are you guys freezing? What are you guys going to do to get warm?
I don't even know. We're really cold. My feet are frozen.
I think we're going to have to go like snuggle or something with some people because I'm freezing.
Please don't get sick. I think the only plunge I would do would be like the tropical plunge, but I don't think there's such thing. So that was awesome. I hope that next year you guys come again and bring more people. For America 101, I'm Sasha Almeida.
That's all for this week. Don't forget Snowflex is open Friday through Monday to Liberty students and to the public. You can find more information at liberty.edu/Snowflex.
Now remember, Option LU is a show by students, for students, and about students. So you don't want to miss an episode, because here at Liberty University, exciting things are happening all the time. I'm Matthew Byrd.
And I'm Amanda Jacobsen. We'll see you next time.